Hello everyone. Today we will be start our English new chapter, A True Story of Sea Turtles. The story is written by Bahu Kharat, who is Sahyadri Nisargamitra. Through this story, he share his own experience with us. So let's start our video. Through this story, the author Bahu Kharat said that their team, they were surviving the white-billed sea eagle in the summer that year. As they roamed the coast, one of the volunteers in their team saw some shallow pits with white eggshells nearby. Inquiries with the villagers revealed that they were the turtle eggs. This came as a surprise. They had never came across turtle eggs in their walk along the beaches of Konkan in all these years. They decided to study this unusual occurrence further. They learned that the beaches where they had found the eggshell had been sealed to the public for nearly 1 month. After people smuggling silver bricks were caught in that area. But what they learned further shocked us to the core. Turtles nest along the entire coastline of our state. There are few people in every village who kept combing the beach in the early hours of the morning. When the female turtle comes on shore to nest and to lay the eggs, she leaves behind the trail just like a track of wheels on the sand. The eggs hunter follow this trail right up to the nest, which is about half a meter deep. They dig up the nest and steal all the 100 to 150 eggs that are laid inside. These eggs are then either eaten or are sold in the market. If a turtle is spotted while it is still laying eggs, it is allowed to leave it. The laying is over. As soon as the eggs are laid, it is caught and then killed and eaten. This ruthless practice is observed in all parts of the world. However, in India, sea turtles have been given protection by including them under the Schedule 1st of the Indian Welfare Protection Act 1972. That means turtles have been given as much protection as tigers. Therefore, all this business of gathering turtle eggs and killing turtle is carried on in a secret, hush-hush manner. This information was distressing. So, author and his team began to think seriously about it. They decided to undertake a project for the protection and conservation of the turtles and their nest in Maharashtra. They had no experience regarding sea turtles, so first of all, they undertook a study of turtles. They contacted institute that work for the protection of turtles in India. The next step was launching a turtle protection campaign at Vilas Taluka, Mandangad district, Ratnagiri. This was done with the support and cooperation of the forest department. As part of the campaign, a few local people were specially appointed to look for a turtle nest on the beach in the morning. When they came across a nest, they had to carefully remove the eggs from the nest and bury them again in a similar pit, but one protected with a wire fencing. They had to watch over the protected nest to prevent thieves. In that year, they could successfully protect 50 nests in this manner. When the babies hatches out of the eggs, What an event that was! The whole village rushed to the beach to witness the spectacle. When the tiny turtle hatchings hurried across the silver sand to meet the rolling boundless sea, what an ovation they received! Some of the elderly villagers confessed that though they had seen and stolen turtle eggs right from their school days, it was for the first time that they had seen the hatching rushing to the sea. Now, in the next para, author said to us, there are 7 types of the sea turtle in the world, 5 of which are found in India. The olive redly turtle nest along the entire coastline of Maharashtra. Green turtles and hawkbills have also been found. An amazing characteristic of the turtle is that when the female turtle reaches maturity, that is nearly after a gap of 15 years, she returns to the shore to lay her eggs at the same place where she was born. The female come on shore just to make a nest in the sand and lay her eggs and immediately return to the sea. She does not return to the nest after that. The eggs hatch after a period of 45 to 50 days using a natural heat. Innumerable dangers await the little hatching in the deep sea, and they have to face them all on their own. Their survival rate is therefore as low as just 1 or 2 turtles out of the 1,000. Turtles perform an important function. They keep the sea clean. Thus, they occupy an important place in a marine ecology. Considering all these factors, it is a vital to undertake their protection on a large scale. In the next para, again we come to the turtle protection campaign at Vilas. After the success at Vilas, they started implementing the project in other places too. Within 5 years, the entire coastline of Maharashtra was survived. Protection was offered in 80 of the villages where turtle nests were found. Their strategy was to engage those who had so far been involved in stealing the eggs, then to train and involve them in the work of the protection. They started the Turtle Friends Award, that is Kaso Mitra Award, to encourage more people to be a part of the protection campaign. A comprehensive booklet and a short film on the protection of turtle was prepared to spread the message. In the next para, author Bhau Kharat shared his experience, which was held in the year 2006. The year 2006 saw the beginning of a novel concept, that is Turtle Festival or Kaso Mohotsav, an opportunity for a tourist to witness the unique spectacle of the hatchings rushing out of the sea. A short film on a turtles and a natural beauty of Konkan were additional features of the festival. At the same time, they were quite firm on one issue: the hatching should not come to even a slightest harm due to this tourist activity. The tourists were accommodated in a homes of the villagers. The response to this novel concept of a homestay was excellent. A turtle friends club was established in each village. The members being all the villagers offering homestay. All villages would now offer the same rate of a homestay. They gave 10% of their income from homestay for a turtle protection fund. The fund would be utilized for the purpose of protection and conservation of turtles. Modern technology also helped. The festival reached all corners of the world through the medium of the internet and our website. People around the world began to contact the small villages of Kokan. More and more villagers come forward to do this work, and the number of homestay families went up to 35. As many as 800 people began to visit villas in a total session. This meant more business for the villagers. Now they realize that tourism can be a source of income. Tourists bring in money, and in order to earn that money, it was important to protect the turtle hatchings. This was conservation of nature through livelihood. In its true sense, villas become the project's main success story. And now, through the last para, Bahu Kharat, the author, said to us that Sahyadri Nisarga Mitra, that is, their organization, believed that it is only the local villagers who can ultimately offer excellent protection to the local species. If they are given the freedom to do that, the conservation projects become sustainable. With this belief, they entrusted the project to the forest department, the Gram Panchayat, the villagers, and their turtle friends club. All of them are holding it wonderfully. Now, they are happy to see the project running smoothly and offer help only when necessary. So, this is our short story. Here we finish our story. I hope you understand the lesson. I hope you understand the story. I would like to end my video by saying that if you have any doubt, any query, any problem related to this story, you can ask in comment section. See you in the next video. For more updates, subscribe and click the bell icon. Thank you.